Welcome back to another Google AdMob tutorial. In our previous smart segmentation video, we went through an overview and some key benefits of smart segmentation. Check it out in the link below. Today, I'll be taking you through some smart segmentation recipes for both interstitial and rewarded ads. These recipes are ways you can start using AdMob's smart segmentation technology to split and monetize different types of users within your app. In this video, we'll be going over four recipes that you can start using today. Those recipes include 1. Monetizing predicted non-spenders. 2. Delivering different rewarded experiences for your users. 3. Lifting frequency caps for predicted non-spenders. And 4. Showing ads to predicted non-spenders earlier. Let's go ahead and dive into each recipe. Our first recipe is monetizing and showing ads to your predicted non-spenders. Smart segmentation helps you predict which users are unlikely to spend within an app and then attempts to show them ads. Doing so provides a simple method of increasing the ad revenue that you can gain from non-spenders of your app while maintaining a premium ads-free experience for your spenders as well as your likely spenders. The second recipe in smart segmentation is to deliver different rewarded experiences for your users. With smart segmentation, you can do more than choose which users to show ads to. You can also show different types of users different types of ads. We recommend you use these capabilities to offer different rewarded experiences to purchasers and non-purchasers. Let's take a closer look at this together. First, the smart segmentation model will trigger a rewarded smart segmentation request. This indicates that we should set a reward item to a high value to our predicted non-spenders. This would attract them to watch the rewarded ad and help us increase their lifetime value via ads revenue. To our group of predicted spenders, we will serve a regular rewarded ad with a regular value reward to avoid affecting their motivation to purchase IAPs. You might be thinking, what happens if my users discover the differential pricing model that I'm using? Will this affect my IAPs? Don't worry, we have the solution for you. Use randomness when offering rewarded experiences for your users. A great example is to use roulettes or random chests. Our third recipe is removing frequency caps for predicted non-spenders. Because the majority of your app users will never make an in-app purchase, you can use smart segmentation to set higher frequency caps for non-purchasers. This works for both interstitial and rewarded ads. For example, let's say you usually put your ads at the end of your game. For predicted purchasers, you would only show up to 5 impressions per user per day. With a smart segmentation ad unit, after the 5th impression, you can show more impressions to predicted non-spenders. In this example, it means 5 more impressions per user for a total of 10. Our fourth and final recipe involves showing ads to predicted non-spenders earlier to maximize the user's lifetime value. We observed that more than half of users churn within the first week of downloading an app. What this means is untapped opportunities and lost revenue for you. Fortunately, the smart segmentation model can be used on users as soon as users download an app, so you can start serving likely churners ads earlier than you would for predicted spenders. Here's how it looks like for rewarded ads. We'll use the same example as before, where you show an ad at the end of your game. If you know that a user has recently installed the app, you can only show an ad to predicted non-spenders who just recently installed the app. For predicted spenders who just installed the app recently, the rewarded prompt is hidden. Along with our third recipe, this recipe is a great example of the variety of variables you can play with using smart segmentation. This feature is not just about showing ads to some users while not showing ads to others. You can also play with different frequencies, timings, and much more. And that's all we have for smart segmentation. In this video, we have shared with you the four different recipes to use the smart segmentation feature effectively. The ability to identify predicted spenders and non-spenders allows you to maximize your users' lifetime value and create tailored ads monetization flows for your users. Thanks for watching this Google AdMob tutorial. We hope you found it useful. Before you go, we'd like to share some resources to make your smart segmentation experience the best possible one. You can find many resources such as our AdMob Help Center and Developer's Guide on Smart Segmentation in the video description below. And one last thing, be sure to subscribe to the Google AdMob channel for more best practices and tips on how you can grow your app further.